Few publications have patted themselves on the back as much as CNN does. Whenever their credibility is questioned, they hide behind declarations of being the free press. These propagandists pretend as if no one has ever questioned yellow journalism, while at the same time creating false story after false story, and even going a step further in some cases. Of course, who can forget back in July when CNN propagandists Brian Seltzer and Andrew Kaczynski, among others, obtained personal information on a Reddit user with the intention of using the information to intimidate a public apology from them. A public apology for making a GIF they didn't like, by the way. CNN also said that they would publish this personal information if the Reddit user ever retracted his apology. Remember how many times CNN has played the victim, pretended that they are being unfairly bullied, but the truth is much more straightforward. They are being fairly criticized by those that disagree with their means. CNN is the type of company that believes that ends justify their means.
From angry tweeting, the president was back at it once again, this time going again at his own FBI, the law enforcement professionals who keep the country safe from things like terrorism. He was also going after the Russia dossier.
The free press. Is this clip that we just watched a great example of what putting your life on the line for a juicy story is like? Aren't there far more dangerous people that they could investigate? And of course, they had to phrase this as the FBI being the victims. Let that sink in. More than a year ago, back when President Obama was in office, there was a flood in Louisiana that came while he was on vacation. And you guessed it, he was playing golf. Instead of coming back from vacation and visiting people in Louisiana for a boost in morale, the Obama administration published a 16-page memo that they issued regarding the Louisiana flood. They warned Louisiana recipients of federal disaster assistance against engaging in unlawful discrimination on the basis of race, color, or national origin, including limited English proficiency. The guidance's frameworks highlight the importance of complying with non-discrimination requirements of civil rights statutes, addressing the needs for the whole community and ensuring equal opportunity to access recovery efforts. Now, the reason I brought up the Louisiana flood and President Obama's response to it is because the same people who were covering for him, running defense for President Obama when he was golfing during a national emergency, are the same people who are outraged that President Trump uses Thousand Island dressing on his salad, amused by the fact that he has 12 Diet Cokes a day, which probably isn't actually true, eats his food with a fork and knife, has his steak well done, has 2 scoops of ice cream. That has been their priority this past year. Nobody is surprised by CNN hiding in the bushes to film Trump golfing, but this should be documented. The next time CNN complains about being criticized or being called fake news, perhaps somebody should remind them of their past and not just the numerous ethical violations that they have indulged in this past year, but perhaps their track record over, say, 10 years. Here are a couple clips.
Crazy. Ted Turner changed the world. I'm a big fan of yours.
Is he?
He would serve you, Captain. You know what I mean? I'm really surprised. He's ready. What's he got left in life, the game? After you're elected, think about it. No dope.
That's for sure.
Great guy to work with.
Kira, let me say this at the start. I'm glad you ran that story, because apparently the only difference between the New York Times and CNN is that when a reporter for the New York Times fakes a story, he's fired, and at CNN he's not. Your bureau chief, John Zarella, deliberately faked the story yesterday, intending to show that the performance characteristics of banned firearms on the list are somehow different from the performance characteristics of firearms not on the banned list.
Mr. LaPierre, I have to stop you there. No one fakes stories at CNN, and John Zarella definitely did not fake a story at CNN. You're very off base. I'm going to let you say your opinion, and let's have a conversation, but don't accuse our reporter of faking story, sir.
Let me say it again, in front of the whole country. Your reporter fake that story yesterday.
You are fake news.
Sir,
go ahead.
Why does CNN get so angry when people call them fake news? This even happened earlier this year when Chris Cuomo said that being called fake news is the equivalent of a derogatory term. You know why it is they get so angry and so sad when people call them fake news? It's because they know it is true. And so do the rest of us.